Today, I'm gonna walk you through everything that you need to know about video file formats. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. And today, I'm gonna help you navigate one of the most confusing and dreaded sides of making a video, file formats. With so many to choose from, how do you know which file format is right for your project? Spoiler alert, most of the time, you'll wanna choose MP4. But let's dive a little deeper and figure out why. First, we should look at the difference between a video file and a video codec. A codec is an algorithm that works all kinds of behind-the-scenes computer magic to make your video file smaller. H.264 is one of the most common codecs. The algorithm analyzes the video image and looks for parts that don't move, like the background here over my shoulder. See how it doesn't change? If nothing changes, then the codec knows that part is the same now as it is for the next 10, 20, or 30 seconds. Then it just tells the next frame to use the same pixel rather than having to save an entire new picture every time. So you end up with a much smaller file size. Pretty cool, huh? But that's not the whole story. A video file is usually a type of file that contains your video as well as key parts like audio or metadata. These are called container files. MP4 is a type of container file. A container usually includes a video that has been shrunk using a codec, the audio that syncs to the video, and metadata to tell the computer which codec was used, how to sync up the audio and video, and even information such as the day it was made. You may have used or heard of other video file types as well. Common ones include AVI, MOV, MKV, MPEG-4, WMV, and FLV. Some of these are older formats and aren't used as much anymore. Others are made for a specific software application or purpose. You won't need to use most of them. When choosing your video file format, you want to pick one that will work across multiple platforms, operating systems, and devices. This is why I recommend MP4. It has the widest compatibility since it's playable on almost any device in almost any video program. And the H.264 codec keeps file sizes relatively small, meaning you can move the file around or upload it easily without sacrificing quality. File formats are always a little confusing, but you can easily cut through the noise and select a format that works for you. Unless you're doing something really unique, MP4 will usually be the way to go. And if you're editing in Camtasia, it's as easy as selecting Share, Local File, and then selecting MP4 from the dropdown. Follow the rest of the prompts and you are done. It's as easy as that. No more reason to fear the dreaded drop-down list of seemingly infinite file format options. As always, if you learned something today, give this video a like and make sure to subscribe to our channel for more great content. Thanks for watching.